Summerville has always been known for its boat builders. A generation ago, schooners were built on this very spot. Selena Lane was just a child then, but she has clear memories of those schooners and the men who built them. They relied on instinct. Many of them couldn't even read or write. They were men like her father, Skipper Jimmy Humby. He's remembered as one of Summerville's greatest boat builders.
The ways and means that those men had to get the schooner together, how I did the work, and how Pop had worked his brain overtime when he couldn't mark down the figures and couldn't mark down the words. He had to memorize everything. So I realize now how stupid I am. Yes, that's the truth. I realize there's no money I got. Not any brains like Pop, nothing like it.
They built the floaters, the schooners that fished the Labrador coast summer after summer. The crews lived on board these vessels until the season was through. They split the fish on deck and salted it in the holds below. Skipper Jimmy Humby built and was master of two of these schooners, the Vera B. Humby and the J&A Humby. More than 20 years ago, Land and Sea's Dave Quinton spoke to Humby in Summerville.
The Vera, the 18th day of April, we lectured up there, and she was 4 months exactly on her blocks from day to day. The day or later came onto the day she went afloat. Exactly. The quickest one that ever went afloat. Not to say in Summerville, but any part of the Newfoundland, I don't care where she's to.
People all over Bonavista Bay know you as a builder.
Oh, just the first, say back 20 years when anybody come to this place, that's where Jim Humby lived, the skipper Jim, or whatever you call me. He said, the builder man.
Pop, hi.
Selena, the builder man's daughter, can't remember when her father wasn't working on a boat.
This is where we chopped out his timbers now and made his models and everything like that for the boat.
And he did it all by hand?
Yes, there was no electric saws then or electric chainsaws or anything then. It was all with hacks and those old-fashioned planes.
Her father often worked until the early hours of the morning, all winter long. Some of his tools are still here, including the model for one of the many trap skiffs he built in this shed.
But he'd make these by hand as well?
Oh, he made all that by hand. Just took a piece of rough lumber, like a piece of pine, mostly he would like to work with, because it's easier to work with. And this is plane. We often wondered, our arm didn't give out steady going with the plane, like that. One arm. And this is workbench there.
So this shed is full of his old things, isn't it? Really?
Yeah. It's just like Pop left it, all that. Yeah, everything, yeah.
Selena had an interest in her father's work from the start. She was taking pictures of his boats as soon as she was big enough to hold a camera. And from the time she was 6 years old, she ordered every nail that went into every plank.
As soon as Pop knew I could write a few words, well, now, you got to write a letter for me. And Mom was delighted, so she that was something she wouldn't have to do. So I used to write the letters for Pop then. On and on and on and on. I always wrote his letters and made out his orders. Everything he orders for the two schooners, I made out the orders.
And it was the schooners that captured Selena's heart. For her, they meant adventure, a chance to see St. John's, a world of streetcars and picture shows. So one spring, when her father readied his vessel for the Labrador, she decided she was going with him. She was 9 years old.
I got seasick, I think, before I left up there going down there. I'm on the water, just the thought of it. But when I got there, I was so happy. It was only just my mind, because when we got in port and the hanker was down, I was number one then.
Mm-hmm. You weren't seasick the whole way to St. John's, were you?
Right. And I still went next year.
And weren't you ever afraid when you were on the water?
Can't remember ever been afraid. I just took it for granted. The men all knew what they were doing. Yeah, took it for granted. Every soul up there knew. Papa always had the good crowd, and they all knew what to do. All knew what to do. I just depended on my life on all of them.
You went to Labrador a good many years, didn't you?
Oh, I I was 49 years, sir. We'd have asked to go one summer more. Make up half a century.
You want to make one more voyage?
One more voyage. And if I get the privilege to go master for anybody, I'm going.
Where would you take that?
But Jimmy Humby never got the chance to make that last voyage. A few years after this interview, he passed away in his sleep. He built until the end. The boat he's sitting in here is the last one he finished. It's still on his son's wharf in Summerville. So is the last boat he worked on. Jimmy Humby cut timber for this boat on the morning of the day he died. As for the schooners, they slipped away as quietly as Jimmy Humby, either lost or sold as the Labrador fishery began to fail. This is all that's left of Summerville's floaters, an old wreck and one shallow arm of the harbor. This and a lot of fond memories.
There's something else that gets in your blood. Like, I bet there's a lot of old people listening to me today and they feel the same. Some that I met in St. John's on the schooners with Papa, I bet you there's a lot of them alive. I'm very happy when I go to the old people's home and meet the old folks that went out Labrador with Pop. A lot of them sailed side by side with them in the schooners that went up out Labrador. And they can speak the same language I speak and Pop spoke.
For CBC News, I'm Pauline Thornhill in Summerville.